And I tweeted, I said, when the FDIC finally approves banks to hold Bitcoin on their balance sheet, everybody will want to buy it. Nobody will want to sell it. And you won't be able to afford it.
Don't be that person that waits until Bitcoin is unaffordable. Bitcoin, there's only 21 million. Don't wait till the masses come. Buy now.
There you have it from Michael Saylor. If you want to hear from more from Michael, you can check him out on his Twitter at Saylor. He's always dropping these gems. Check him out here. Bitcoin bros agree with him 100%. Don't wait until the price is unaffordable. Buy while people aren't thinking about it. Start stacking sats if you haven't done so already, and diversifying your dollars, your hard-earned money, and don't let it get debased and inflated away. And with that, what's happening, crypto crew? Sean's coming back at you, another cryptocurrency video. And getting straight into it, we have an update from Stock Money Lizards, and he's showing you this fractal pattern. What it seems like, we come back, retest this before we come back up and retest it. And he's basing this off the GMMA oscillator. And he did this for the past three cycles and see where we could potentially be going. Well, the Bitcoin bros plotted this out for you. We're going to take a closer look. The first one, back in 2014, the 2015, 2017 bull market, you see we had this downtrend. And this downtrend had a fall through. We came back, retested, got rejected. And then this blue line acted as the resistance until we broke through it, retested it, bounced up. But you see where we came back up and tested before we got rejected. That was this level here where we wicked above, came back, hit our head. This is around the $750-ish dollar range. Then we come back, get rejected, and we form this new upwards trend line. So once again, the trend's your friend to the end. That's the blast off. Rinse, repeat. Let's look at the bear market of 2019 up until the previous all-time high back in 2021. You see, we hit our head, came back down. We had two wicks above this and then sort of hit our head, wicked down, and then started that downtrend back in 2019. And right here, this level was around the $12,000 range, and look where we came back up to. We wicked above the 13.8, got extremely overbought, then got rejected back to this macro support line here, the new support that was formed. So this is something to keep in mind. People are saying, are we going to see lower price action? This is what we have to pay attention to, because right now at the current time it's recording, Bitcoin's coming in at 26.8K. Could we go lower? It's definitely a possibility. Because why are we saying this? Every time we come down and test this line, we sort of grind against this upwards resistance, put in higher lows and higher highs before we pop up to make that run up towards a new all-time high, but we fall short, run into resistance, get rejected, come back down and retest this line. This line, once it's retested again, this is around the halving, so it only gets tested once, twice, then a blast off. So back here as well, came back once, twice, then the blast off. So where we're at right now today, we tested it once. And the thing is, this is a little different. The timing could be a little different because you see we came back up and we tested it twice. So is this time a little bit different? Are we going to see a once, twice, come up, run up to this $48,000 level? And Stock Money Lizard also called out this level. We do agree with that. The trend's your friend and history repeats. And if we do that, will we have some type of price action like this? We come up, get bullish, run into the $48,000 to $50,000 range, run to resistance, and then keep getting squeezed from this line. So is this line the line we should be using? Is this the upward slope? Because as you see, these two previous upward slopes have acted as, you know, a trampoline. Bounce, bounce, run up. Bounce, bounce, run up. That's for this red line, this red line. Is this red line still being formed? Do we have this drawn to scale correctly? The reason why the Bitcoin bros are saying this, because one thing to note, each one of these red lines before, the intersection from these previous resistance levels always had some space after the halving. This space here, but right now, this line, the space doesn't happen after the halving. So how is this going to look? And if it gets above this space, you're putting in a new all-time high before the halving. So are we going to put a new all-time high before the halving? Are things going to change, or is history any indication of what we can anticipate and expect? So if we zoom into this price action to see where we are right now, could this be drawn a little differently? Could we draw it out this way? So now we have a little space after the halving, similarly to the others. So it would look something like this. And if you look here, and this could have been retesting that red line, and then we maybe are going to run into this maybe next month, next 2 months, around this $28,000 level towards the end of the summer, and then have that bump up towards that $50,000 threshold. But that still doesn't leave it a lot of space. So are we going to set this floor a little bit lower? Are we going to see something like this to where this gets extended? And now there's enough space for us to come up. We could see something like this. We could sort of trend sideways a little bit, come back down to retest this, have that run up towards that $48,000 to $50,000 threshold up here, and then sort of cool off going into after the halving. Bounce off this, then run up. Or we could come down a little bit faster, bounce up, then run back up and put in a new all-time high. How is this going to look? We have to wait and see if this floor has been set. If this floor hasn't been set and we come down either this month or next month, we could see a $23,000 to $24,000 Bitcoin, maybe a wick below, down to $22,000, $21,000 potentially. That could be in the cards. But either way, you see one, whenever that happens, two, then you'll run up. And looking at the previous cycles, it only happened after once. So one, then you come up, two, then you run up. So that'd be a little different if that's how it plays out. Or we could just trade a little bit sideways, gain some momentum, and not have a second retest. We could see something like this, where we just sort of stair step our way up and then come and hit this and have that second retest. So we still have that one, two, then off to the races. So yeah, we have to pay attention to see if we could see some lower price action, or if we're going to be just heading up to the top, heading up to this $48,000 to $50,000 threshold before the halving. This is our target if we get bullish before the halving. We could trade sideways the rest of this year and then get bullish after the halving and break past new all-time highs after the halving. Just because it's happened in the past doesn't mean that has to happen again. Another update, this is showing from Ether Nacional, showing that there's also some bullish momentum because of this bullish cross. It happened in March of 23, July of 2020, and May of 2019. That's when we ramped to that 13.8, July of 2020. This was post-halving action. And once again, back here in November 2015, well, this is actually pre-halving action, this cross. So this is something to pay attention to. Are we going to run up? This is showing like an $80,000, maybe $70,000 Bitcoin before the year is out. That means that Bitcoin will do something it's never done before, make a new all-time high before the halving. Are the four-year cycles still intact? Something to pay attention to. A huge warning, we want to show you guys this. This happened recently. Over $35 million in cryptocurrency was stolen from Atomic Wallet, a self-custodial platform. And one person suffered $8 million loss in USDT. So that's a lot of money to lose. You got to be self-sovereign. You got to be your own bank. And you got to want to hold your own crypto. Do not rely on any third parties holding your cryptocurrency for you. Now, with the Ledger debacle, there are some alternatives you can use for Bitcoin-only wallets. The Bitcoin bros have taken a look at ColdCard. You can check out more of them at ColdCard Wallet. Sleep at Night technology, ultra secure, probably one of the most secure devices for a hardware wallet. And it has the air gap functionality. That is definitely a plus. It's verifiable source code, easy to use, and ultra secure. Only for Bitcoin, not your altcoins. You can still use alts for Ledger, but if you're feeling easy with Ledger, this is an alternative. And we have Charles Hoshishkin, the creator of Cardano, and he's talking about some of these scams with artificial intelligence. They're getting really intense. Check out what Charles has to say.
Unfortunately, there is something on the horizon which is going to create substantial problems for many, many, many people. So this is a video from NVIDIA. It's a supercut of a keynote in Taiwan that the CEO of NVIDIA did, talking about all the cool, interesting things that NVIDIA is working on. So, for example, they're doing some cool stuff with real-time ray tracing. And then he says, hey, look, I can just use some text and I can generate basically a photorealistic video game and actually have Jin's voice. And, oh, now we're going to talk about, like, generating this woman right here. She's completely fake, but we can actually make it seem like she's alive and well. And, oh, look, we can do 3D video of a person. Wow, isn't the future great? Well, the problem is this technology is growing exponentially. And as a result of it growing exponentially, what will occur within a 12-month to 24-month horizon, so likely next year, will be that videos of me can be manufactured using generative AI. Audio of me can be manufactured using generative AI to make it appear that I'm calling you, talking to you, or soliciting your money. So the problem is that thousands of people are going to fall for that. No matter how many of these videos I make and warn you about it, no matter how many times I say it's a scam, it always will be a scam, you don't get something for nothing, you don't get something for nothing, people are going to fall for it. It's called a confidence scam. And as a result, millions of dollars worth of ADA and other cryptocurrencies will be stolen. This is the world we're heading towards because of generative AI. It's one of the dark sides and unintended consequences, but scammers are already doing this.
You want to be aware of what's going on. You want to be cognizant and get ahead of the scammers. Do not engage with any cryptocurrency celebrities, even if the Bitcoin bros are quote unquote reaching out to you. Do not engage, because we're not going to do that. We're not going to be like, hey, let's partner on this, or hey, let's do that, or here's how you can get some free Bitcoin. Stay away. Red alert. And understand that this is the next generation of what's coming for scammers. Artificial intelligence is extremely powerful and extremely useful tool for the world. But one thing to be mindful of, there's a negative and downside to it as well. And there will be people that lose out, that lose their crypto, lose their Bitcoin, and understand that this will happen, but don't let it happen to you. I'm Sean with the Bitcoin Bros. You guys like this content, go ahead and smash the like button. If you haven't subscribed to the channel, go ahead and show us some love. We appreciate the support. With that, that's all I have for you today. And I'm out.